Hi, this is Susie Leventero. We're going to do a quick air signs. I'm going to do a love horseshoe spread. And I'm just going to redo the air signs. All right, so let's see. So we're going to start with Gemini. Okay, Princess of Wands, Summer. The Fool, new beginnings here. Ooh, and trying things you've never tried before. Okay, and Four of Pentacles. Okay, Orion energy there. Hangman. King of Wands, the Chariot, the Five of Cups, and the Nine of Pentacles. Okay. I need to pull out one more. I need to pull out another card. Okay. Wow, this feels like a Cancer reading. This could be for a Gemini Cancer cusping because this is feeling a lot like Cancer energy. This whole reading. Okay. Anyway, let's get started. Okay, so. Okay, so whatever this love journey was, it started out kind of fun and playful, and it's like summer of love, kind of fun, playful connection. Okay, so then you, it was fun, playful connection. You were just like, kind of like a, let's see how where it goes kind of thing, right? Just not really putting a lot of thought maybe into it. Okay, and then I feel like with this Four of Pentacles and the Hangman together, so I feel like whatever, it started out this way, but then there was like kind of a, I don't know if it's dependent energy or clingy or needing this person, oh wow, that's interesting, because this morning I channeled whack-a-mole, and this man is has a club here. Okay, you know that game, whack-a-mole? Okay. So I feel like whatever this experience was like, maybe more like a senses kind of connection, like having to do with the senses, because I'm getting a feeling of caveman, or for it could be alpha male, okay, energy here. All right, now, and then here is the Pisces energy. Okay, now for some of you, if this Orion energy is here with this Neptune, this could have been an Earth sign that was vibrating in a negative place. Okay, so. And I think that's probably where the shift happened here, starting here, and then it shifted. Okay. So, I'm picking up today, there was some dynamic here where there was freedom wanted, and if it felt a little bit maybe claustrophobic than what this person was used to, maybe. All right. Okay, but also it could have started when Neptune went into retrograde and then they woke up and then they weren't in that kind of dreamy fantasy world back here. They were like, they woke up and they're seeing the reality of their existence and what they needed to do and accomplish. Okay, so I might have to actually label this Gemini Cancer cusping energy. Okay. All right. So, here is the King of Wands. Okay. So, I feel like at this stage you were still passionate and wanting to move towards probably a more stable union. But okay, so okay, so you were, I feel like you were this, the King of Wands, passionate, okay, so, and then perhaps you had a child here, okay, all right, so, also, if it wasn't a child, it was some sort of progression towards relationship. Okay, so that could have been birthing a business, things like that together. Creating something new together. Okay, now then what happened? Okay, then something fell out. Now, over here, we have Nine of Pentacles and Seven of Pentacles. Okay, so I feel like if you're this person, if this is a she was looking to you, and I feel like felt like you weren't giving the attention that this person desired at some point. Okay, Seven of Pentacles, but still wanted to work on it. Okay, so it was like doing this in her mind or his mind, right? And then but also having to deal with that Neptune shift. Okay. Right, now let's see what happened here. Okay, Five of Pentacles. Okay, wanted to pursue money because there was some sort of issue with money and perhaps. Okay, so something happened around money, okay? Because here's the Tower card. Something happened around money and fighting, maybe around that. Or it could have been this person wanting to pursue her career or wanted more recognition. Yeah. Okay, so Jupiter is shifting into Pisces. So I think I've done the same reading before. Anyway, there is potential to renew this. Here's the Pisces and then the Moon. Okay, so Jupiter is heading to Pisces, the transit, and then here's Two of Wands. See, there's a new potential coming in. Okay. Or you could take the first steps towards it. Okay. Let's see. I feel like this person is still working on healing and being her best self. Okay, so if she's a mother, she might be trying to balance all that out. Okay, Prince of Wands. What is that? Okay, child. So this is most likely someone with a child then. Okay, but it could be birth of a business for somebody. Okay. And that person trying to work those things out. Okay. And then if this isn't the child, then this would be who, two things. A person you think is interested in your person that is younger than her. Okay. Or this is her. Not really appreciating the connection, maybe, is how you're seeing it. And she wants to travel here with this Sagittarius in the middle. Or there could have been a Sagittarius entanglement here. Okay, now, Three of Wands. Okay, so there's looking on both sides. Okay. Okay, and the reason why that person hasn't made the moves is because there were some sharp exchanges before. Okay, so let's see your attitude. See your attitude. Ooh, respond with grace. Okay. All right, so let's see their attitude. I feel like that's in the middle, actually. Yeah. Okay, and then shameless sensuality. Okay, so this person is still attracted to you. Okay, and vice versa. Okay, and this, I feel like both sides feel this way. Now, this kind of reminds me of okay, so, but anyway, interesting. So, sometimes I don't know why this is coming up, but it must be. Sometimes there's this thing, and I don't know psychology as much as some people, but sometimes there is like underlying thing in the subconscious about when a person gives attention to the child, then sometimes a man feels left out. But here you're showing up as the deer, which is nice energy. So, and that actually is symbolic of Gemini in a lot of ways. Okay, so the key is for both sides to open the mind, it says. Okay. Choose love. I feel like this person has. I feel like it's on your side. Okay, so do you see this as a hindrance? Okay, look to the future. Okay. I feel like you've been looking to the future. What I'm picking up here is many transformations that add up to a big transformation. And there's like wind here. Okay, so particles, right? Watch your belief system. This doesn't have to do with love, but I feel like, are your thoughts soft and fluffy around the universe, or is it like feeling like the elements can get you? Because this is like a soft embrace, I feel like, this wind here, right? There's butterflies and daisies. It's like a soft wind. Okay, so if you have a certain belief system that's causing the particles to move in a some kind of way, then what you want to do is deconstruct that thought and put in a new framework because you have control of the elements. That's a little aside. It's not part of this. It's more with having to do with work. Yeah. Illusory obstacles. So, what do you feel like is coming at you? Some sort of belief system. Can you deconstruct that thought or at least purify it? The dragon's here. So that you don't create that in the future again. Whatever it was unwanted there. And I'm getting door knock. So it's like they're showing me like door knock. And then it's like speak. So, what are you saying with your words that created that experience that was unwanted? Take a look at that. Feel like it has to do with the cosmos. Okay, but let's get back to the task at hand here. It says grow together. So, this has kind of been a message, is like, kind of harmonizing all the energies so that whatever you move towards in the future can be successful, right? And I leave you with that. Thank you, Gemini, Cancer.